time set to kick off here, and it's not a home game for either of these teams. Before we head down to the field for the coin toss, we'd like to remind you this game is brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coke taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. UCLA is lined up for the opening kickoff, so here we go. Nice kick, plenty of distance. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line. Now the offense gets ready to take their first crack at it. Quickly, and he's got his man, and they make the stop at the 22-yard line.
That's how we do, D. That's how we do. They don't
number 92 makes the tackle at the 22-yard line.
From their own 22-yard line, it's second down.
Watch 35. Watch 35.
Quick throw to the tight end. A nice completion to the tight end.
A good play here, and the thing that I notice is that he provides a nice big target out there for the quarterback.
Scrambling, and he's going to be sacked for a loss.
This quarterback has to do a better job of avoiding the rush, because sacks can be real drive killers.
From their own 26-yard line, second down. He's on the run, and he can't get away from the pressure. It's third and 14, ball on the 26. Catch, first down, and he's knocked out.
They had a long, long way to go, and the receiver managed to just get enough to pick up the first down.
Roger, roger. Mike 35, Mike 35.
He scrambled, and he tackles him hard at the 45. And he didn't get much on that scramble before they drilled him.
Brad, that's a great way for the quarterback to get himself injured. He needs to be a lot more careful out there.
Second and 7. Ball on the 45-yard line. On the ground, left side. He fights forward to about the 46. And this play is number 8 on the drive.
Mike 35, Mike 35.
He's scrambling. The ball pops free. The defense has it. And down he goes around the 49-yard line. And that one's recovered by the cornerback.
Funny, because you usually don't see corners down there picking up loose balls. They're more worried about interceptions.
So the offense will come out for their first possession.
Good field position for their first possession of the ball game. Let's see if they can capitalize off of it.
Throws incomplete, knocked away.
If you wonder now if will get alligator arms the next time the ball comes his way. It's been known to happen.
From the 49-yard line, second down, a quarterback in the gun with 5 receivers. Tackled after decent pickup. They'll spread the field with 5 wide.
taken down
around the 38-yard line.
I thought there was a chance he'd be brought down before getting to the marker. It was a great effort there to get beyond for the first down.
They'll bring him down at the 37. Wide set. Throws incomplete, intended for his wide outs.
You know, sometimes the toughest throws to make for a quarterback is when he has a wide receiver wide open, and everybody in the stands is saying, throw it, throw it. And you aim the football instead of just getting back in rhythm, stepping, and throwing. And that time, he aimed the ball, and it was incomplete.
And it's good! To kick this one away. And he got all of this one. Great kick. He's to the 20. And he's tackled at the 25. UCLA's in the driver's seat right now, but it's still early, Kirk.
Yep, very early in this game, but you got to love the feel for it as far as they're concerned. They came up with a stop, and then they get points, and right now they're out of the game.
And while they are behind, they know they can knock things up in a heartbeat. It's way too early to change your game plan. Made at the 25-yard line.
You know, sometimes the defense just has a beat on an option, and there's no way the offense can gain positive yards on it.
So it's second and 10. Ball on the 25. Makes the catch, and he's got nowhere to go. So it's complete, but they didn't get much there.
And that's because the defense was just waiting on it, and they attacked. The quarterback should have found somebody else downfield.
In the middle. That's a great tackle at the 31. They pick up at the most 4 yards on the screen play. And he makes it out to about the 41-yard line. We're about set to start things up again. Quarterback all by himself in the backfield with 5 wideouts. He's on the run. He's at midfield. UCLA is up a field goal. He tries to buy some time. He's at the 30, slides down to the ground.
It's always a snap decision when you decide to tuck it and run. On that play, it was definitely the right move as he got the first down after a nice game.
Tosses out to the tailback on the screen. He's taken down at the 22. That's a deal. Pass is caught. The defense lays him out. Oh, we had a pitcher's duel in that low-scoring first quarter. The Bruins in front, 3-0. We can only hope the second quarter is as good as the first. Tight ball game, folks. They come out on an empty backfield. Out of bounds around the 14-yard line. So it's fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. for it on the ground, and he's not going to get there. So they turn it over on downs, and that's a big boost for this defense.
In a close game like this one, it's big plays like this that can be the deciding factor.
In a game that's this close, you can't afford to waste possessions. Feeds it to the back. Nice run to the outside. They're about 4 yards away here on second down. Brought down at about the 29-yard line. Tackled at the 38-yard line. Short yardage situation here. Second down and one. He's tackled right around the 46-yard line.
That makes it first and 10.
To his receiver. He's at the 30. Brought down near the goal line.
That makes it first and goal.
First down. Knocking on the door here. It's first and goal inside the five. And the goal line defense digging in here. And he has it on the corner. Touchdown, Florida State.
That is great tough football right there. Getting down to the goal line and just punching it in.
Splits the uprights with the extra point. A six-play, 86-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass. Just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
He's to the 20. They'll bring him down at the 28-yard line. With one quarter down, I really haven't seen too much separation between these two squads. Might be neck and neck the whole way.
The offensive lineman played that one perfectly, giving the tailback plenty of space to work with, and he took advantage of it.
Complete. He's got room. Tackle around the 47-yard line. They keep it on the ground with a tailback. He makes his way to about the 38. They get nice yardage on that run. They go right back to him, and this time they get him in the backfield.
It's a great play by the defense, but you know, it really makes you wonder, was there a miscommunication up front by the offensive line? They just seemed to allow the defensive line to get through, and the running back didn't have much of a chance at all.
From the 35-yard line, second down. They give it to him again, and he's going to lose yardage. Sends it out quick, intercepted. And he is drilled at the 14.
It looked like the pass was sailing out of reach, but he just climbed the ladder and made a spectacular interception.
First and 10. Ball on the 14. Florida State holds a four-point lead. The middle for a nice game. The Seminoles taking their first time out of the half. So the draw to the halfback picks up four. They hand it off again, and they'll bring him down behind the line. UCLA's going to take their first time out of the half. It's third down and six to go. Ball on the 18. He's gobbled up in the backfield.
Those linebackers do a great job of stopping the run, but they need to be careful of the play-action pass. You can easily get fooled and give up some big yards through the air.
Tackle made at the 44-yard line. You know, we're getting so used to pinball football with a lot of points. Kind of fun to see defenses play this way.
Kind of refreshing, isn't it? I mean, every single week we call games and you're seeing scores in the 30s and 40s. This is one of those low-scoring games. Which offense will get that big break eventually could be the team that wins it.
He's going to try and scramble. And they got him. Scrambling around, and they make the stop around the 45-yard line.
That makes it third and 11.
So an empty backfield with five wide receivers. And they bring him down for a sack on the play. And long here after the sack. Excellent punt. This punt bounces into the end zone, and this will be a touchback. Momentum swings have been fairly even, and with so little separation, this game can be drastically changed on just one or two plays. Florida State is up four. Makes it to the 22-yard line. From their own 22-yard line. It's second down. So at the end of the half, Florida State leads 7-3.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio as always to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. One thing has been apparent in this first half that we just saw, both defensive coordinators a step ahead of their counterparts on offense. They've had the answer for every formation, every shift, every movement, every motion that they've tried to come up with. So to try to break free and get something moving on offense, might it be time to show a little trickeration?
A little trickeration never hurt nobody. I mean, it's something that if you keep doing what you've been doing, you're going to keep getting what you've been getting. And you got to find a way to do something a little bit different because it wasn't working. Let's find some new plays in that book. Let's run a little bit of option. Let's run some reverse. Let's run some double passes. How about we bring a blitz with everybody? Just don't even cover anybody. Just bring everybody. Bring the house. You know, try to do something a little bit out of the ordinary. Try to get a spark going for your ball club.
David and I will be keeping an eye on your game and everything else going on in the country here in our palatial and comfortable surroundings in the studio. The best seat in the house belongs to Brad Nessler in Kirkhurst Street.
Great first half and a tight ball game, and we're set to start quarter number three. He'll return it from the one. He makes it out to maybe the 23-yard line. The Seminoles continue to get it done on the defensive side of the football, Kirk.
Yeah, they've done a good job of building this lead and almost determined here to protect it. Let's see if they can hold on here for the rest of the way.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Fires out to his wideout, and down he goes around the 31-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
He makes it out to maybe the 33-yard line. He steps up, catches it, and that's all. Now he's scrambling. And he's taken down at the 45-yard line. Gets out to about the 45-yard line.
No gain on the play. That makes it second and 10.
22, back 22. I'm on.
Check three. Fires quickly, and he's got his man. They'll bring him down for a loss on the play. Down, and they need to get it down to the 35.
Mike 22, he's coming. 22's coming. Mike.
Hit as he threw, and he completes it. They'll knock him down for a loss.
That's a loss of 2 yards.
Trying to change the field position with his kick. Both squads are digging in now. Let's see what happens on this next drive. Florida State is up by four. Bring him down at about the 25-yard line.
That was just smash-mouth, helmet-to-chin football by the defensive line there. They dominated the point of attack.
It's second down and 11 to go. Ball on the 25-yard line. He makes it to the 28-yard line. And the halfback carries for a pickup of three. To the tailback. Tackle made at the 29.
down at the 42-yard line.
I just love to watch this defense play. They've been flying all over the field today, making big play after big play. The crazy thing is, we still have such a close game despite how well they play.
There's still plenty of time to keep running their offense as usual here. I don't think they need to feel any anxiety about trailing. And he tackles him hard at the 50. Here's an opening. He gets to about the 34-yard line. Makes it to the 14. They failed out here the last two times. Pulls down the catch, and he's got room here. He's knocked out of bounds at about the 9-yard line. He makes it to the 6-yard line. Point. And he adds the extra point. They line up to kick this one away. He sends this one deep. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback.
Well, this is a competitive game. It's fun to watch these two teams go back and forth. Just when you think one team has the edge, the other gets right back into it. This is exciting.
This deficit can be easily overcome, sure. But they have to be thinking if they don't get something going on this series, the burden is going to be felt by their defense. Off balance throw, got him anyway. He's taken down at the 43. It's first and 10. Ball on the 43-yard line. Got it and brought down immediately. To his receiver, brought down at the 44. We've got a first and 10, ball on the 44. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Quick throw out to the receiver, and he's tackled around the 36-yard line.
That makes it second and 2.
Some daylight. He gets to about the 27-yard line. First down, 10 to go. Ball on the 27-yard line. And they get the sack. Boy, this defense really came to play today.
Well, they said before the game that they wanted to put a lot of pressure on this quarterback. They sure stuck to that plan.
We head to the final quarter, and we've got a great game on our hands. 10-7, Bruins. We're just about set to start action here again in the fourth quarter. Get to that quickly. He's tackled right around the 30. Third down now. They need to get it to the 17. Quick out to his receiver. That's a great tackle at the 16. We're at play number 9 of this current drive. Throws to the receiver, incomplete. Second down, 10 to go. Ball on the 16-yard line. There are 5 wide receivers split out. The quarterback in the gun. Slings it. Tackle at the 13.
That makes it 3rd and 7.
It's the 11th play of the drive. Catches it and hit immediately for a loss. 5-yard loss.
This defense is fast enough that they can create negative yards on completed passes. So the offense might want to consider that next time they try that play.
They'll call on the field goal unit here. The kick is up, and it's through the uprights. And with that field goal, we are all tied up.
Yeah, that was a clutch field goal without a doubt.
Florida State to kick. Sends it sailing downfield. And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback.
The defenses have certainly been the story in this football.
No doubt about it. The defenses have been dominating on both sides of the ball. But one play from either of these offenses could determine the outcome of the ball game.
You've got to be aware that capitalizing on this drive is crucial. You want to take the pressure off you and put it on your opponent. Quick pass, intercepted. And they make the stop at about the 31. From the 31-yard line, first down. There's a strike complete. And down he goes at the 25.
Number 8 makes the tackle at the 25-yard line. That'll make it 2nd and 4.
He's on the run. And he's taken down at the 21-yard line. So it's 3rd down, and they're just inches away from picking up the 1st down. Less than 3 minutes in the game. Looking for the corner. He's pushed out of bounds at about the 11. To catch it. He's got nowhere to go.
Number 35 brings it down. He's got the 10-yard line.
2nd and 9. Ball on the 10-yard line. Caught out in the open. And he is drilled at the 3-yard line. Down, FSU.
Penalty markers down. They took too much time.
Delay of game. Offense.
Just under two to go in the game. And he tacks on the extra point. Everyone's all lined up and ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the one. Tackle at the 22-yard line. Let's see what they can do on offense as they take possession after the return.
But this is something you work on over and over and over, whether it's two-a-day, spring football. Year-round, the quarterbacks study two-minute drills, which quarterbacks run it effectively. Well, here it is. It's right in front of you as a quarterback. You know what you need to do. You need to know about your timeouts. You need to know if the clock is moving. You need to manage the game and do it quickly to give yourself a chance to score a touchdown.
Second and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line. Gets rid of it quickly, and that was almost picked.
You never know what will happen when the ball ricochets like that. Good effort by the defender.
They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's tackled at about the 23-yard line. Fourth down, and the offense is still on the field. He lets it fly. Tackle made at the 41-yard line. And he's tackled at the 38. Just over a minute in the fourth quarter. Couldn't hang on here in the fourth quarter. Third down now, and they need to get it down to the 31. To the halfback on the screen. He's taken down at the 43. UCLA is going to use their first time out of the half here. They'll need something really big here out of their quarterback on fourth and long. Wow, what a battle and what a stop right there. Congratulations to that defense. That's going to be the ball game. The whistle hasn't sounded yet. They still have to snap the ball and make sure they don't make any mistakes. And he makes it out to about the 44-yard line. UCLA will take a timeout. That's their second of the half. From their own 44-yard line, it's second down. And he carries the ball for a nice gain. UCLA's out of timeouts. Bring him down at the 43-yard line.
Awesome running here on third down. That can bring a lot of confidence to an offense when they can pull that off so successfully.
From the 43-yard line, it's first down. We should just see the quarterback take a knee right here, winding down the rest of this clock. He takes a knee, looking to take some time off that clock. And this one's all but wrapped up. The Seminoles come out on top, 17-10. Thanks for joining us for another game of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk and everyone here at EA Sports, Brad Nussler saying goodbye, and we'll see you next time.